G'day guys, Lemon Eating Cow here, and today I'm back playing Horizon on the PS4. And in this guide, I am going to show you how to get the ultimate armor, and it pretty much makes you invincible up to a point anyway. This guide is going to involve some pretty heavy spoilers, so if you haven't got a fair way through the game or near end game, then please turn back now. Spoilers, spoilers. So you can actually get access to this armor. Well, see it anyway, pretty early on in the game if you head to the bunker. But the thing is, you need 5 power cells to be able to unlock and use the armor. So the location of the first power cell is actually in the bunker that you were in when you were a little girl and you found your focus. But you're not actually going to be able to access it until you come back here as an older alloy. So once you come back here with your spear, you find a part where you can break some stalactites here, or yeah, stalactites, I think they're called, or malactites, I don't know, one of those. Anyway, bust through those and you will find a green icon donating a power cell at this location, and all you do is pick that up and you've got your first power cell. So the second power cell is actually going to be at All Mother's Embrace. You can get it when you wake up after the proving, but if you missed out on it, then you can also get it any other point in the game. Usually when you come up to the base, you'll see the second door there closed, but the way I got it to open, all I did was run to the right of the camp and all the way down to this bridge here. I'm not sure where the exact triggering point is, but I know once I hit that location and come back up here, you can see now the second gate is actually open and we can access the All Mother's Embrace. If this doesn't work for you, I think you pretty much have to wait until near the end of the game before you get access to this area again. Regardless, when you get access to this area, all you have to do is run through and take the forked entrance on your right and then down a little bit and into the room, and you'll find the power cell. Now, if you come here just after the proving, you'll have to squat or duck through a little a vent or a small enclosed space, which is on the left over there at the right of the screen, and the entrance is actually here. So all you have to do is maneuver through those and you can pick up the cell. So for the third power cell, you are gonna have to be at or after the Maker's End quest. And once you've reached level 12 or floor 12 of this big tower, you're going to come to a space with a big like boardroom meeting table and some hologram dialogue going on in the middle. Instead of going towards that table, turn around and look for the yellow studs that denote a climbing spot, and climb up this all the way to the top of the tower, and at the top you will find your third power cell. Once you've grabbed that, just rappel down or fast travel out and head on to your fourth power cell. So the fourth power cell will be located in the Grave Horde or the Grave Horde quest. Again, you can get this either as you're doing the quest or afterwards coming back, but I suggest getting it when you're actually doing the quest. So at a certain point during the Grave Horde, you will reach a section that has 3 switch puzzles over 2 floors. The first two are pretty obvious to solve, the answers will be on the terminals, but the third one, the terminal will be blank and you'll have to listen to the audio codecs to work out the solution to this one. So the positions of the switch for the third puzzle is the first switch you want to go up, the second switch you're going to put to the right position, the third switch you're going to put to the left position, and the fourth switch you're going to put to the down position. Once you've solved that puzzle, it's just a matter of heading back upstairs and accessing the door that you just gave power to. So this is the door that we just solved the puzzle and opened up, and once you open it up, your power cell will be right there in front of you. And that is your fourth power cell, only one more to go. So the fifth power cell can only be obtained after or during the Mountain That Fell quest, which is pretty much one of the last, very last missions in the game. You're gonna need to get it to a point where you take a zip line down, one zip line down. This will be after you have taken the override chip or the master override chip. It's pretty obvious at the point once you get to it where this section is. But yeah, just after that first zip line, instead of going ahead where the marker shows, turn around and you will see a hang point. All you do is climb up it and come to this section here on the map, and we'll find our fifth power cell. Now that you've got your fifth power cell, we're just going to have to head to the bunker that actually houses the armor. And it is located here on the map. You can fast travel to the fireplace where I am at the moment. And then it's just a matter of heading over here and scaling the mountain and then heading down into the bunker. Now again, this bunker can be accessed at any time if you just want to check out the cool scenery, but until you actually have these five power cells, you're not going to be able to do much in there. So once you're here, just head down in the bunker. Probably don't do as I do right here, but yeah, I'm sure there's some safe way to get down there. Anyway, head on in and you'll see your beautiful looking armor waiting for you, but it's going to be behind a couple of switch puzzles. So we're going to use two of our power cells on the first set here, and then we're going to solve the switch puzzle, which is each section relates to a time. So we've got 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 9 o'clock, and 12 a.m. So the first one we're going to put in the up position, or leave it in the up position. The second one is going to go to the right position. The third one is going to go on the down position. And the second from last is going to go on the left position. Once you've done that, you'll get access to the room that has the armor, but we're still not finished yet. We still have three power cells to go. But you can see the armor, which looks pretty damn fine up there. Once you've had a good look at the armor, come around the back of the armor and you'll find another switch puzzle. Put in your three remaining fuel cells, or power cells. And then we're just going to have to solve one more puzzle. Now this puzzle deals with the various degrees of a circle, with each increment or quarter of the circle being 90 degrees. As you can see there, all the different displays are on the terminal. So for the first one, we're going to turn it to the right. For the second terminal, we're going to put it in the left position. For the third terminal, we're going to keep it up. For the fourth terminal, we are going to go to the right. And for the fifth terminal, we are going to turn it all the way to the left. Of course, you should turn it with the X square button instead of the circle, but anyway, there you go. And that is the last set of locks and the last puzzle that we need to get the actual armor. So once you've done that, all you have to do is run around to the front of the armor and pick up this beauty. It will actually give you a box instead of the actual armor, so you have to come down to treasure boxes, open up the Shield Weaver outfit box, and then go to your outfits and put the armor on. Now, really, unfortunately, it doesn't look as badass as it does when it was hanging up. I really wish it had kept the helmet and the cool kind of cyborg look to it. But it's a pretty darn good armor anyway. Now, the great thing about this armor is that it lets you take a lot of damage before you actually take health damage, and it is constantly regenerating. So in battle, usually when you get hit, the little shields will pulse a kind of blue silver, which means that you're currently taking no damage. But when you notice that the suit is starting to pulse red, that means the shields are worn out and you will start taking health damage. If this is the case, just roll around a bit for 10, 20 seconds and the shields should come back up again. So anyway guys, I know that guide was a little bit long-winded, but I thought it was necessary to include as much detail as I could. I hope you don't have any trouble finding this armor. If you did enjoy this guide, please leave a thumbs up. If you've got any comments or suggestions, then leave them below. And if you haven't subscribed already, then please do so. This has been Lemon Eating Cow. Thanks for watching. Moo!